Welcome back. We have so much to get to right now. Are you ready for this? You've probably, of course, been told and heard, and you think this, that you have to save as much as you possibly can for your retirement.
So why could it be a problem to save too much in your retirement accounts? Les Szarka from Szarka Financial, who's going to tell us now to hide it in the mattress, folks.
Yep.
Hide it in the mattress.
Yeah, buy but a first, safe. Where's my bacon?
Right. We've got some for you.
Oh, you're hoarding it. There you go.
He's going to make us some bacon, folks. He's going to make us some bacon.
Bring on the bacon.
Bring on the bacon.
Come on. Saving too much for retirement. What do you mean by all that?
No, I'm not saying you shouldn't be saving for retirement. I'm talking about where you're saving it for. You absolutely should be saving more for your retirement.
Okay. I mean,
as you know, this generation gets older and older, you know, pensions the way of the dodo bird right now, so less people are having access to pensions, and you're having to rely more and more on your own savings to be able to support your lifestyle in retirement. The purpose of today's session is really just to talk about where you're saving it.
So you where know, should you be, you're trying to, if you're working, maxing out like a 401, that kind of thing?
Correct.
Right. Then what else? IRAs?
Well, there's a problem with that, though. So if and I see this all the time, when someone retires and they have 90, 95% of their money, their assets, in retirement accounts. So here's the complication with that. When you go to retire and you take money out of that account, it's fully taxable. Mm-hmm. So I see this all the time where someone says, well, I want to buy a car, I want to take a vacation, so I'm going to take $20,000 out of my retirement account. Well, gee, guess what? You just have to pay another $7,000, $8,000 in taxes, potentially. So that sometimes that inhibits the person from actually doing what they want to do. If they had another pool of money that they could access that wasn't taxable, then that obviously would be more beneficial.
Which is what? There's got to be one,
pool.
Right?
Well, there's other ways you can save for retirement. So, you know, to your point, yeah, you want to try to most of the time max out into your 401k. If you have additional monies that you can afford to save, then you want to take a look at maybe just regular brokerage accounts that would normally be taxable, but you can control the taxes within that account. So, you know, if I'm going to put $1,000 or $500 a month into an account towards retirement, and this is after I've put something aside for my 401k, you know, maybe put it into account where you're putting things like tax-free bonds or more tax-efficient type investments, you know, like maybe ETFs, you know, the index that don't throw off a lot of capital gains. So when you finally do hit retirement, you can access that money not at fully taxable rates. So the tax-free bond income would come out tax-free, obviously. You know, if you had stocks in there, you'd have to pay just capital gains, which, you know, might be either 10 or 15%, not the full weight of whatever your tax mm-hmm. bracket is. So it's gotten a little bit more complicated, because what we're seeing now is this trend from the government. It's kind of a money grab where they're looking at these trillions and trillions of dollars in retirement accounts. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they're like, well, how can we access some of this money before this person, you know, reaches retirement age? So I know a few years ago, the Congress floated a trial balloon that wanted to tax what they deemed were excessive retirement accounts, you know, that they thought were too big, and wanted to levy a tax on those even before someone retired. Now, it never passed, never really got any traction, but you got to be careful when the government starts sending out trial balloons, as to kind of gives you a hint as to the direction that they're heading. So, you know, I would just be careful in socking everything away into a deferred retirement account, and maybe diversify it a little bit more, and just put some monies into a non-retirement account. So that gives you more flexibility once we go into retirement. But also, if you needed that money before retirement, you could access that without the taxes and the penalties.
Is your head spinning? That's why you gotta lean on the experts, folks.
Yikes.
And I wish I had one of those dodo pensions.
Dodo pensions,
those dodo pensions, that was fantastic. I really enjoyed mm-hmm. that. Anywhere else we should put our money real fast? We gotta run.
Right now, I would be a little bit careful what's going on with the coronavirus. I would just be a little bit cautious. I'd wait a little bit to see where this thing actually leads out. Just as a quick note, everybody's talking about the coronavirus. Last year alone, I think it was 60,000 people died of flu-like
flu.
here in the United States. So before we get, you know, too far out on the limb in terms of panicking, mm-hmm. now that's not to say this isn't a major concern. I would just, you know, be cautious.
But it can affect your money.
It
and
will affect your
property
money.
Value and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Les. As always, if you have financial questions and need more information from Szarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, fox8.com, and click on Seen on TV. He will answer all your questions,
brokerage
no matter how
accounts. And you said ETFs?
ETFs, again, those don't throw off a lot of capital gains.
Okay, thank you.
And gold.
I took my notes.
And gold, absolutely gold. Yeah.
Gold's going up. It's going up, Les. Not
well,
today,
times
but
like,
every day
times like today.
Today.
Yeah, there you go.
Wait, I Les, I like your gold chocolate bars.
Oh, man, fantastic.
Okay,
awesome.
Next time.
Awesome.
Bacon.
Awesome. Yeah, we'll trade you. Bacon
gold
for
bacon,
gold chocolate.
I'll take the bacon.
You got it. It's a deal. Still to come.